Are you guys looking for a long-term steady method to help you study from the start of the semester and the one method that really works? If so, you've come to the right place. Hey guys, I'm Dr. M, and today's video is divided into three parts. The first part being, what is spaced repetition? The second part deals with why to implement this method. And the third part is about how to implement it. So what is spaced repetition? So spaced repetition means revising what you have studied in certain intervals of time, and these intervals increase as time progresses. So let's say you just studied glycolysis today. You will probably revise it as soon as you have finished studying to check if you know it completely. But many students stop here. Or some students take one more step further and revise it the next day, then move on. But spaced repetition method does not allow you to stop here. After you have revised the next day, you'll be revising it after 2 days, then after 1 week, and so on. And you'll be doing this until it gets completely embedded in your minds. The fact that this method would be good for improving studies for the first time was proposed by Professor C. A. Mace in his book, Psychology of Study. Until now, countless number of researches have been done studying this method, and every time, its efficiency has been justified. So why do you need this method? In medicine, there is something known as the forgetting curve. If you look at this curve, it shows that you'll clearly forget anything you've studied over time if you don't revise it. This method is all about revision. But the good thing about it is that it will make you revise stuff over a certain time, especially when your brain is about to forget it. Because extensive research has been done while developing it, it will work. However, you can modify the intervals of time as per your convenience once you get the hold of it and know what works best for you. There has been research in justifying this, and one of them suggests that student doctors forget a staggering amount of information they studied only in a period of 1 year. Doctors are those professionals who cannot afford to forget whatever they have learned, so this is scary. This is also the reason why when you watch any of the videos made by doctors teaching other doctors how to study in medical school, they always mention spaced repetition. It does work. Now, how do you implement it? Now, you might be thinking that this method is scientific. It has a fancy name, and Dr. M says a lot of research has gone into it. So it must be really complicated, right? Wrong. It is really simple. Also, considering the fact that there are a number of softwares that will automatically organize your study intervals, it is really simple. The only thing difficult about it is that you need to study properly and log in time to revise. Because I am not sponsored by any such softwares, I do not choose to take their names. But there are a lot of such softwares out there. But if you decide to implement this method without the help of any softwares, what you can do is, after you have studied something, you can revise it in intervals of a day, 3 days, 7 days, 2 weeks, 1 month, and revise again in about 3 months after that. If the concept is still not completely in your mind, you can take it even further. And if you think you need to change the intervals, feel free to do so. But the thing is that whenever you revise the topic, don't just open the notes and start skimming. You should close the book and try to remember what you have studied. This will force your brain to do some work, and hence brain will remember it faster than ever. And hence guys, this was my video on spaced repetition. I know you guys might have a lot of questions, and if you do, feel free to drop a comment down below. I would also love to hear from you guys about the topics I should cover in my next videos and the stuff that I can improve. Guys, I have a Patreon account if you want to help me out for making these videos. My computer needs an upgrade, and I need a few devices to operate my mic. I literally make these videos in Movie Maker, so yeah, it is difficult. Check the link in the description box below or that iCard on the top to go to my Patreon page. And even if you don't want to pledge me on Patreon, please like, share and subscribe, because it really motivates me too. Thank you for watching guys, and I hope you have a beautiful day.